Hello and welcome to the Fairfield Dynasty. Today is finally the day we've all been waiting for. It's been a long time coming. It's the season opener and the first game in program history for the Fairfield Blue Devils. We'll be at home today against the Louisiana Monroe Warhawks, and it should be a fun game and fun to finally see this team take the field in live action. We will receive the ball to start, as it is Rashard Scruggs and Trevon Bullock back to return it. It'll be Scruggs out of the end zone, and he is brought down to the 25-yard line. Darius Douglas is coaching his first game today, and it'll be fun to see this team take the field. Spencer Clay under center from the I formation, and Dominique Frederick is brought down for no gain. Now we'll go shotgun, give it to Frederick. This time he has more room to run and gets 5 yards. You can see Dominique Frederick, he's not the fastest guy, but does have some good quickness. He's more of a one-cut runner and has good ball carry vision. On third down and 5, it is caught by Adrian Schaefer, the senior tight end. Spencer Clay will get the start. He is a pocket passer. He is the best arm on the team, although we may see some of Terrence Lake. It'll be a split back set on third down, and it's Schaefer once again. He breaks the tackle and picks up 20 yards. That's 2 third down conversions. Second down and 10 throw, and TJ Cross can't bring it in. He drops the wide open pass, and that'll bring up third down and long. Clay drops back, throws it down the middle of the field, looking for Schaefer for the third time on third down, but Wesley Thompson knocks it away, and we're forced to punt the ball. It'll be Evans back to throw. He finds an open man, and Brown, who breaks a tackle and gets to the 40-yard line, already inside of Fairfield territory. The leader on defense is Carnell Blackshear. He's not the best athlete overall, but just is a skilled linebacker. Under center, it's Evans, who will drop back, now take off. He finds a running lane, gets a big block, another nice block. Burks can't bring him down, but he does step out of bounds at the 10-yard line. A flag on the play, clipping called on the Warhawks, which will back them up. Under 5 minutes left in this first quarter, it's Peterson on the catch. He fights his way forward for 15 yards inside of the 25-yard line. Second down and 10 for Evans. He will escape the pocket and take off. He stiff arms the defender, what a move, and is inside of the 10-yard line. It'll be goal to go under center. It's Gore on the carry, who fights his way into the end zone. It's a 7-yard touchdown as Louisiana Monroe has a 7-0 lead. We'll be back on offense. It's Frederick to start this drive as well as he picks up 9 yards. It'll be third down and 2. Clay will keep it on the read option. He finds a hole, makes the defender miss, and picks up 9 yards. Spence comes in motion. The give goes to Frederick, who's able to pick up 6 yards, a good run. Under center is a twin tight end look. The handoff goes to Dominique Frederick. He is able to convert a third down there, the fourth for us on the day. Now a throw outside. TJ Cross is lit up, but hangs on the football this time as he picks up 8 yards. We'll go back to the ground game from the single back set. And after picking up the first down, Dominique Frederick is shaken up and will be forced to leave the game. The backup, Dontarius Butler, comes in, but it's picked off by Hubbard, intended for Tavarius Edwards, and it looks like Hubbard's going to take it all the way to the 10, and he will score. A bad throw right there from Spencer Clay, as that will extend the lead to 14-0. It will be Terrence Lake to start this drive from the full house set. He keeps it on the read option and picks up 14 yards. Lake is more of a runner between the two. He's a decent enough passer, but definitely not the same passer that Lake is. We'll stay in the full house. Bake it to Butler. It'll be Lake who keeps it, now pitches it outside to Marcus Macklin, the third string running back, and he gets 11 yards. Clay comes back in, and it'll be the I formation give to Butler, who's able to pick up 2 yards. Clay's in on third down and 6. He dumps it down, and TJ Cross once again drops it. He's struggled so far with 2 drops. That'll give the ball back to the Warhawks, as this time it is RJ Turner for the 15-yard reception. And the pistol will go to the air once again down the field. It is Green. Marcus Green, the star wide receiver for Louisiana Monroe, is pushed out of bounds by Marcus Gilchrist. Now we throw outside. It is Brown, who stiff arms the defender, brought down by Brooks Strickland, the starting strong safety. In the pistol once again, Evans will take off, but this time he's brought down before he can escape. It's a sack and a loss of one by Byron Roach. He is our starting defensive tackle. They'll go to the air once again, and Ron Turner has it. RJ Turner, I should say, has it for the 14-yard reception. Inside of the five, it'll be Evans keeping it, and just trucked Brooks Strickland there, and gets into the end zone for a 21-0 lead now. Both sides of the ball struggling for the Blue Devils. Our offense has to get some points on the board before this game gets even more out of hand. A nice carry there from Dontarius Butler will go play action, and it's Adrian Schaefer once again, this time for 14 yards. He's been the primary target for Spencer Clay so far today. And the single back set, it'll be Butler once again. He picks up 4 yards, and that'll bring up third down and five. A quick throw, it's Schaefer, and is able to pick up the first down, pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Three wide set, it'll be Clay, and Cross with his third drop of the day, and he has cost Clay 3 completions so far today. It'll be CJ Sander on for the kick. He knocks it home. We get our first points on the board as a program. Gore gets it, trucks the defender, and is brought down. That was Brooks Strickland, I believe, getting trucked once again. He's definitely undersized for a strong safety, so you should see us run a lot of two high safeties this year. A good stop by our defense there, as is a quick throw to Antonio Lawson. He is there for a 7-yard reception. He'll be the slot receiver. He's a shifty guy at 5'8". Now the possession receiver of the team is Tavarius Edwards with this 6-yard reception. Clay will go to the air once more. He throws, and Lawson this time can't hang on the football. That's the 4th drop as a team. Third down and 10, setting up the screen pass for Dontarius Butler. He can't break the tackle, only able to pick up 3 yards. The Warhawks use a timeout and get the ball back with 48 seconds left. A ton of running room here for Evans as he's pushed out of bounds by Trevon Bullock, the number one corner for the Blue Devils. It's a drop back for Evans. He'll throw it outside to Brown, who breaks one tackle but is brought down after a first down pickup. 10 seconds left, throw outside to Gillespie, and Dre Dixon can't bring him down, and it is a touchdown as we will now go into halftime down 28-3. You have to make the tackle there, but instead we will go into halftime with a four score deficit, as this was a tough first half. It's something we might should have expected with the level of talent on this Fairfield team. This is not a bad Louisiana Monroe team. They have a lot of talent on offense, but we definitely need to see our offense pick it up in this second half. The Warhawks will start off with the football to open, and it is a 9-yard reception for Demarius Gillespie. A 4-wide set, Evans will keep it on the read option. A ton of running room once again. We have got to do something to slow Caleb Evans down. He has run the ball all day today. Now they'll give it to Gore as we play the quarterback, and it's Gore picking up 12 yards, as even when we try and take Evans out, it's Gore picking up. Now the backup Vaughn is in, and he fights his way into the end zone. Austin Vaughn on a 14-yard reception, now 35-3. We'll open in the full house on this drive as Dominique Frederick is back in the game. That's good to see. Now the quick throw, it's Turner on the interception. And he breaks one tackle, breaks another, and is brought down inside of the red zone. That's Clay's second interception on the day, as he has struggled for the most part. Caleb Evans is sacked by Carnell Blackshear, the leader of the defense. And we get a look after the field goal. 43 plays, 171 yards for our offense. And we're going to need a change as Terrence Lake comes into the ball game. TJ Cross gets the catch, doesn't drop it this time, but cannot make the defender miss. Third down and 7. Lake will go to the air. He finds Cross and just shy of the first down line. But the offense will stay on the field. I formation, Kenny Spence. He's able to pick up the first down and our drive will continue. Now third down and 2. Frederick is stopped of the first down line. Just like we went for it last time, we'll go for it this time. But this time it's a keeper for Terrence Lake, who picks up 4 yards. It'll be Macklin checking into the game along with Dontarius Butler. And the pitch goes to Macklin, who's picking up 2 yards. But Macklin is shaken up on that play. It'll be a full house set once again as we're into the fourth quarter. And on the keeper, Lake picks up 13 yards, as this is one of our best drives so far today. Now throwing outside, a great catch by Dominic Frederick. He's a very good receiver out of the backfield, so that's something we'll definitely have to utilize. We have two fullbacks in the game now as the give goes to Frederick, who picks up 8 yards. Some nice power football right there. Now I formation, Dontarius Butler. We go power football once again, and Butler's able to punch it in for the first touchdown in school history. Evans has the ball. Marcus Shaw can't bring him down, and neither can Strickland, but he is finally brought down after 12 yards. A 4-wide set. Gore gets the carry, and it's a good stop by the defensive lineman Byron Roach. Third down and 10 under center is Evans. He throws outside and nearly intercepted by Deontay McBride, the number 2 corner for this team. Lake stays in the game, and he throws to Schaefer for 9 yards. That's another catch for the senior tight end. Second down and 1, and the pressure gets there. It's a sack and a loss of 9 yards. We'll stay empty on third down, and the draw play does not work out. Another loss, and it's a loss of 2 that time. We punt the ball away, as there's now under 4 minutes left in the ball game. Green breaks a tackle, and he's going to score it, as tackling has been a big issue. It's a 38-yard touchdown. Back on offense, nice run here by Dominic Frederick. He powers his way forward and fights for 17 yards. Great yards after contact there. I formation as Frederick once again. He finds the hole and some good blocking as it ends up as a 15-yard gain. This time is Lake on the keeper as he's able to slide and pick up the first down. Under 2 minutes left now. We'll go play action, setting up the screen pass. Frederick on the catch, breaks one tackle but can't get away from the second defender and ends up losing 3 yards. Just looking to put some more points on the board before the end of this game. A good dump off to Darren Childress, the number 4 wide receiver, who is brought down to the 16-yard line. That's a 13-yard gain. Third down and 9, 19 seconds left, and hit as he throws, going down. That's Lake's first incompletion on the day as he is shaken up. It'll be CJ Sanders on for the kick, and it is good. And that'll give us 13 points on the day, a 32-point loss, and the inaugural game for the Fairfield Blue Devils. Caleb Evans was outstanding, 4 touchdowns, over 300 all-purpose yards, was very good for the Warhawks. Our offense started to put it together a little bit better with Terrence Lake. We'll get an update on his injury in a little bit. But overall, just really struggled. 48 yards passing for Terrence Lake, 81 yards on 4.2 yards per carry, only 2.8 for Dontarius Butler. Adrian Schaefer by far was the best receiver we had today. And then on defense, Rashawn Gilchrist III leads us in tackles, 2 sacks for the team, but we did not force any turnovers. You can see the team statistics as we had 181 yards and 121. But we will move on into week 2. This time we have a rivalry game against the in-state rival, the UConn Huskies, who were able to win their first game of the season. David Pendle, a very good quarterback. He is a dual threat guy. They won by 10 against an FCS team. You can see the only points for FCS that they played came in the third quarter. So overall, a good performance. Did not score a whole lot on offense, however. A look at their offense. You do have a good number of wide receivers, just like Louisiana Monroe. We're going to have to slow down a dual threat quarterback once again. Hopefully he can do a better job this time. I hope you did enjoy today's episode. If you did, please leave a like down below. Leave your comments on the game down below. What do you think the keys are for this upcoming game against UConn? But like I said, I hope you did enjoy, because I'm out.